So we're going to remove this radiator and put in a Dewitt's two-fan regulator. There's a lot of YouTube videos on how to remove a radiator, but there's nothing really on how to install a Dewitt's. So I'm going to change that and hopefully put one on. So I'm going to take out this bolt, that bolt over there, and then take out these two bolts, and then most likely, since I'm not going to save this shroud, there's a lot of different bolts, and probably not all the bolts were put in, because I'm finding that throughout the build or dismantlement slash builds in this car. So I'm going to see if I can, it's plastic, so I may just cut it in half and pull it out, because I'm not going to save it. Move those two bolts half inch. So I have a lot of stuff like this kind of tucked in here, and I'm going to start tearing through some of this stuff. I'm filming by myself, so I'll give you an update after I'm done. So they're off, both of them, and there they are. What I'm going to do is sand them down and spray paint them. I'm going to remove the fan now, and I'm going to try to avoid the belt removal. And I'm out later. It's all done. It's knocked it out of place. This radiator looks like it's been leaking down the bottom and over there. So there's no saving this thing. So this thing's going to be shit canned. So the lower radiator hose and the upper radiator hose. Next, I'm going to pull this baby out. Almost forgot. This is a manual transmission. So I don't have any transmission lines going into the radiator, so it should be ready to go. So I couldn't get the radiator to come out at all initially after I removed the shroud and removed the hoses. So what I did is I got a mallet, kind of lightened it up a little bit. I'm not going to keep the radiator, it's busted, so, but I used it. So what has happened is it's rusted to the bottom, to the pan that it sits on. So I hit some mallet, and then I put a tire jack underneath it, and was very careful not to just to touch the radiator. And I popped it up a couple times, and then it's nice and loose now. But it's rusted, so I'm afraid to look what's underneath it. But it's come free. Bottom isn't too bad. It's not too bad a rust. A little surface rust. It looks like nothing too critical. I am degreasing it right now, and then I'm gonna put some of this stuff on it. 415 before I put in the new radiator. Here's the old radiator. Looking at it upside down, but looks like it's had some damage. That may have been caused by the pulling it out. It wasn't very nice when I pulled it out, but looks like there's some water damage. It's time for this baby to go. Started the unboxing a little early, but there she is. Cool, we pull her out. So this is the 1973 black combo. It's a ticket number or part number 32-4239073M as in manual. Again, I ordered the black ice with the I ordered also the black covering there, the cap. That is a part number 32514B, and again the radiator is 32-4239073, M as in Mike or manual. So there it is. goes, maybe. Wow, cool, pretty, that's for sure. Oh, I don't see any correction, so gotta figure that out. She's a beauty. Yeah, the wires coming out. So you have the red positives, so both the red positives from this guy connected there will connect to these reds, two reds for dual fans. The gray goes to the sending unit on the radiator, which is right there. I had guessed that it was gonna go to the block, but I'm gonna rather go there, that's a good place. And then the orange, that goes to the ignition switch. So both oranges, I'm gonna tie them together and both come off the ignition. And the yellow goes to the battery, 12 volt battery, it actually says it on it. With the fuse and LinkedIn. So then the gray sending unit, orange, ignition, yellow, battery, red, hot coming off of the fans. It's fan power. Here's another look at the diagram. That's all you get. So I just got off the phone with DeWitt, and this is what some of the advice they gave me. They said SPA includes a 30 amp fuse and a 40 amp fuse. Go with a 30 amp fuse if you have a C3 or this setup. This is gonna be cut in half and spliced and as close as the battery as possible. This extra component is if someone just ordered the fans, and this is where I ordered the fans and the radiator. There's the sensor that they, temp sensor that they recommend hooking the gray lines to. But in the case of someone just ordered a fan, they would get this so they could put it in their block or their exhaust manifold. What else did he say? He said that the two wires that are going, the two orange wires going to the ignition from both fans can be spliced together before they go to the actual ignition. And the ignition should be hot when the on auxiliary and hot when cranking. So I'll test that and see how that works, make sure that's the case. Another thing he said that was interesting is that once I get everything hooked up and I take the gray wire off this, I can just touch the gray wire to the radiator and the fan should come on for both fans. You can do them individually or do them both together, but he said just to make sure that that works correctly. Also, once you get it up to temperature, when you crank the car up and they stay on, they don't come on initially, but they come on when you make the temperature that they need to adjust to. Let the car run for another 2 or 3 minutes, maybe 5 minutes, and then shut down. And the fans should shut down too. There has been reported problems with the fans continue to run. And then I'll call them back if that's happened. We'll troubleshoot that problem. The battery, you run, of course, this piece all the way as close to the battery, the fuse as close as the battery as you can. With the yellow wires, two yellow wires, and it doesn't have to go to the battery, he said. I'm going to run it to the battery, but he said for C3 Corvettes, they'd go to the hot lead on the alternator. I'm gonna go ahead and run those all the way to the battery. I won't run the ground to the battery. The ground's gonna just be grounded on the chassis. The three grounds that I'm gonna worry about is this one. This one's provided and attached to the radiator because the radiator sits on cushions, rubber cushions, and so you may not get a good ground. And this is started by having a good ground. This is how this knows that its temperatures, the fans need to come on. So this is supplied to go to the ground. And then when I ground this, I'll ground it to the same place that these two, these lines are gonna be grounded to. So all three will be grounded together. And that's about it for me right now. Hopefully, I asked him for all the advice he could give me, and he's like, this is what it is, should be easy to go. So, wish me luck. It kind of gives perspective. Going over to the passenger side. There's my two fan relays. I'm gonna mount there temporarily until I get everything figured out, and I'm probably gonna tuck them under here, underneath. This is the radiator overflow catch. I'm gonna mount them in there and kind of tuck them away with some nice cable management and make them out of, get them out of the way. Hey now. So far what I have is, I have the two reds coming out, going through the wires, and going to the, where I'm gonna drop the radiator. Two grays going over there. The red's the power to the fans, and the grays are to the temperature sender that will tell the fans to kick on. And then I have the two yellows going in through the firewall, and we'll run those to the back to the battery behind the driver, coming underneath the vintage air system, and gonna go in here and conceal. The same area I have the VA system wired to, power wire. And then also I have the orange two wires coming through, and those are go to the ignition. Have those running under the vintage air unit into the empty radio area where you can see it kind of hanging out. I'm gonna wire those to the auxiliary sender for the fuse boxes where they need power on and power cranking. This is a mess because I haven't had any cable management, but you can see the two gray lines I was talking about. Of these wires, the two yellow go inside to direct power to the battery. Two reds go to the two small fans, direct link. Two oranges go to AC power. And the two grays, again, go around, all the way around. Have them wired through here. And I connect them to the trinary. Can't really see them, I've tucked them all away. Here's one of the blue wire ground, and the other blues come around over here. I mean, the grays. And I spliced two into one, and you can kind of see them all right on the sender here. There they are. They're not gray because I had to extend them with a larger wire. This is how I hooked up the trinary switch for that configuration. One green and black line was going to, I went to ground. The second green and black went to the vintage air blue wire that goes all the way to the front to the fuse block running 12 volt power. And then the two blue lines coming off the trinary switch, one went to my temperature sensor In this case, I had a temperature sensor on the as part of the radiator, so it went to the radiator, and then the other one went to the VA vintage air compressor. So I just hooked up a toggle switch option for my electric fans on my radiator, and it was pretty easy. I'll show you the diagram in a sec, and it was a kind of something that I thought I needed. Initially I didn't, but with stop and go traffic, I noticed that my compressor was kicking on and off and the fans were coming on and off as the pressure increases or decreases. The temperature really wasn't a situation because the Dewitt's radiator is so efficient. But I noticed that if I kept the long as the fans were moving, the air was colder inside. So now that if I'm in stop and go traffic and I noticed that the cooling isn't as cool as I'd like, I want to have that option. So now I do. So I'm running it the temperature line. I have a line going directly to the temperature gauge on the radiator, and it comes in, and I have it right now being ran all the way down here and coming into the cockpit right there. I'm gonna clean it up a little bit later on to kind of see it. The Dewitt's radiator has a temperature sending unit installed in the actual radiator instead of in the block, which is a nice feature. So I have that connected there. It's going into the cockpit, going into right there, and it comes into this toggle right here. And this is going to go right in here. And years ago, my dad had this is the horn that he had put in the vehicle. So if he needed to use the horn, someone really pissed him off. He could go down there. The horn didn't work at the time, so he had this is the horn switch. And now I have the horn working, so I just use that toggle, and that's going to be my manual fan override. If the fans need to come on, that's the way they're going to come on if I need them to come on. So there it is when it's installed. Barely noticeable. Doesn't get in the way. Like I said, that toggle switch has been there since I was small, very small. It's been with the pretty much the entire life of the car. It just never worked. Now it has meaning.